title of his message is called The Top of the Pyramid. Top of the Pyramid. Amen. We are at the, if you have, I'm not going to do PowerPoint, but I was, but I won't. I'll just, because it's not necessary. Everybody knows if you've ever seen a dollar, then you know on the back of your dollar, there is a pyramid with a capstone suspended above that pyramid. The capstone is illuminating, or it's light, because it stands for Lucifer, the light bringer, light bearer. Now, it's suspended above the, y'all got a dollar? I don't want your dollar. I'm saying I want you to look at your dollar. I don't want your dollar. Get a dollar. If you don't got a dollar, share a dollar. Share a dollar. Find a dollar. I want y'all to see what I'm saying. Grant got dollars. Elder got dollars. You need a dollar? Ask Elder. Elder got dollars. Give Elder this dollar. I'll give you a dollar back. Now, you know, on the left side of the dollar, all right, you see the pyramid on the left side. I'm not dealing with the right side. The right side, I can tell you, is something. It's a whole nother. Actually, it's the Egyptian. I ain't got time to go in there. Look at the right side, because I want to show you where we are. Now, you see, this is 13 steps pyramid. And above the pyramid, suspended above the pyramid, is the all-seeing eye, or the capstone. The capstone is suspended above because at the time that they were forming America, the goal of America was to build the foundation, or the 13 steps for the pyramid to be built, so that the capstone could come and rest or take over the system that they built. So the system, it ain't gonna be that long, what I'm saying. The system that's being built is the 13 steps. That's the foundation of the New World Order. The capstone is Lucifer, or the false Christ, or the Antichrist, that will appear, the son of perdition. He will appear. The Bible says that the kings and the false prophet give their power to the beasts. So what they have been doing is they have been building a system for Lucifer to take over. Now, they put it right on the back of the dollar because Freemasons really hide everything in plain sight. It's very important that they put their symbols in front of your face, because that's how they speak and talk to one another. If you ride to certain parts of the city, or certain streets, you will see a Masonic symbol, and it's telling you that this jurisdiction is maybe under a certain lodge, or so they're speaking through their symbols. The reason why they use symbols is because they stole the religion from Egypt. Freemasonry is white Egyptian worship. They stole it from Egypt, and if you know what Egypt was, it was all about signs and symbols. They spoke through signs and symbols. They deciphered those signs and symbols by stealing the books from the Library of Alexandria. That's how they act like they don't know how to read that stuff on the wall, but they know exactly what that stuff is saying. That's the reason why they took the religion, and then they formed America based upon trying to recreate Egypt. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? So this is what you see. That's what the back of this dollar is all about. Amen. Now, I may touch on it a little more. I just want to show you so you get a little bit of reference. Now, are y'all revelations? Y'all revelations? Say the top of the pyramid. Now, Revelations chapter 13. Look at verse 16. Today I want to show you why the upheaval, why this crazy racial strife, tension, this old racism is stirred up again. You know, seems like there's it's so much tension, it feels like something's gonna pop any day now. We have economic turmoil. I was looking at Venezuela. These people are running across the border just to try to buy any type of food. That literally the whole country, Venezuela, big country, is totally broke. And every country is falling like dominoes to the IMF bankers, to the Jewish bankers, actually. And it's happening all over the world. And it seems like somebody at the top is just squeezing everybody into one, like into a small group. Like they're squeezing everybody into a small channel. The same way all these corporations are buying each other and coming together. You're getting one corporation that done bought up 10 corporations and all the banks are becoming one bank. Because everything, that's the pyramid. Everything is going into one to give that power to the beast. So that the beast will come, or the Antichrist will come and set up a totalitarian system where he'll be able to monitor. Now we know how they can monitor us, because everything we got, we're paying to be monitored with these phones. These phones are the last step for the chip, because you're already being tracked. Everything you're doing and saying, they can cut the microphone on. There is no such thing as privacy. Everything that you've done has been recorded. Every email you've sent, every picture you've looked at, every website you've been on, they are going to use that against you one day. So don't think that you're going to, and one of the reasons that's going to break, I'm going to tell you what I believe is going to happen. They're going to really break Christianity, because they're going to show the hypocrisy of all those people who say they're Christians, what they've been doing online. Everything's recorded. Everything you do is recorded online. Every conversation you have on your phone is recorded. There's nothing that you put in the digital world that's not captured. Are you understanding what I'm saying? So the whole goal of the beast system is about data mining. In other words, getting as much data on people as they can. That's why now if you go anywhere, if you go to a store, you buy something, they ask for your zip code. They ask for, like, this is cash money, but for some reason they want more information on you. Because anything that they put in digital goes in a file called Prism. This is what Edward Snowden was talking about. You have files on your life. And the file determine by that file what philosophies and beliefs you carry. Are you understanding what I'm saying? All right, now. But this is how the beast or the Antichrist will monitor everybody based upon this system or web or net that he's building. Now, Revelation chapter 13, y'all there? Look at verse 16. And he calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark. Now, I told y'all what I believe the mark is. We have many people that think they know what the mark is, but on their foreheads, on their right hand, or in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell. Now, this is a physical mark. That's why, listen to me, I do not believe it's a RFID chip. I don't believe that, because the Bible says it's a mark. Right. You can see it. So I don't believe a RFID chip, you can't see it, it's under the skin. So I don't believe that it's a RFID. I believe that may be part of the beast system, but I don't think that is the actual mark. I believe the mark is a mark. The Bible says it's the number of a man, the number of his name. Total 666. There's only two, sort of the two triangles total six. I mean, there's different things that can total six, but anyway, I don't want to get into that today. But the mark is going to be a mark. Are y'all there? Now listen, it says now, and that no man might buy or sell. There's the New World Order system. You won't be able to buy or sell. That means you'll be locked out of economic advancement. You will not be able to buy anything in our society. Now that means food. You literally would, they can hit a button in a computer screen and you'll be a nobody. So you got to realize the war on cash. We're going to a society where there's no money, because cash is something that they cannot really track, and they want to track everything you do, so they got to get rid of the cash. So then a person, all they have to do is not physical money, just hit some zeros on the button or erase some zeros in your bank account, and there you go. You don't have anything. So that's how they're going to control people. Now you got to realize through what these elite have been doing is they have been gaining control of all of your energies, your water, and your food, because those are the main things, those basic necessities that are going to control people. Are you understanding what I'm saying? When you're hungry, your baby is starving, it's going to be real hard not to take a mark. That's why they're going to put people under that level of pressure. Are y'all there? Now, I don't want to really stay too far on this. I don't want to give you a setup for what the New World Order is. Then look, it says, and that no man might buy or sell, save he had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. Now here is wisdom, let him that had understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man. and his number is 600 3 score and 6. So it's not a IFD, it's not a RFD, RFID chip, because it's the number of a man. Now, I don't want to really get too deep into that. I've done a teaching on this before on the Mark of the Beast. You can go look it up. I think it's called The Evil Star. You go look it up. Now, what I want to show you is we understand that there's a new world order coming. We understand there's a one world government being formed. What I want to show you is not only is it, I want to show you detail. Say detail. I want you to understand detail of this new world order. It's happening now. It's being formed now. Say now. That's why it's very important to be all the way in Christ. No time to play around and don't know what you believe and halfway in. And no, you got to be all the way in. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Got to be all, whatever God got for you, you want it. Whatever the Holy Spirit, whatever, everything he has, you want it. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Because those that are halfway right now are going to get knocked off. I'm telling you, it's going to be very hard to stand in this last hour. Now, what the new world order is in modern terms, in not biblical terms, we'll call it the new world order, but in worldly terms, it is called Agenda 2030. Write it down so you can study it. What you're seeing going on with the racism, as if this is a new thing. No, they're stirring this up. This is purposefully done. All these movements and protests, and all of a sudden we shooting, killing each other, and the media just going crazy because this is part of the agenda of Agenda 2030. Now let me give you some information. The United Nations, now I'm going to give you just some research so you will know what the New World Order is and what it looks like and what they're doing. You'll see what's happening once I put it out. You'll see what's happening. It's a blueprint for global enslavement of humanity under the boot of corporate masters. In other words, corporations will be controlling the people. These multinational corporations will literally be your leaders. And that's the reason why I told you all these big businesses are buying up little businesses and they're becoming bigger businesses. And now if you look who owns what, you'll see GE owns this and that and that and this. And it's like a monster. And what they're doing is the whole goal is to bring all of these businesses into one. Are y'all there? Now, this article in Natural News was an article done by a guy named Michael Snyder. You can look that up. And it was entitled The 2030 Agenda, which means by 2030. This is what they want by 2030. Y'all got that? Amen. Now, it says this month the UN launches a blueprint for the New World Order with the help of the Pope. The article references this UN 2030 agenda document that pushes a blueprint for so-called sustainable development around the world. Remember that word sustainable. That word sustainable is another word for population control. What they're telling you is the earth does not have enough resources to sustain the current level of people. So we need to do something in order to cause the earth to so that the resources of the earth are not depleted by all of the people we have. So what's the goal of the elite? To kill everybody, to decrease the numbers. Now, this goes right along with the Bible when it talks about when the Antichrist comes to power, that he's going to begin a killing campaign. You're there. He's going to begin a killing campaign. And so this is the reason why. Now, you got to realize these people that are at the top are Luciferians. They believe that if they do Lucifer's will, they will become immortal. They will live forever. That's what he's promised them. And they believe that. And that's why they don't care about killing or whatever they have to do to get there, or what they believe is eternal life to become an immortal. And so so the goal is to decrease, is to kill. Are y'all there? Now we know that's what man thinks the goal is, but what Satan's real agenda is he hates you because you were created in the image of God. So every time he snuffs out one of God's innocent ones, he puts that in the face of God to hurt God. That's why he does what he does. That's why he wants to kill you. Also, he's jealous of you because he feels that you should be where he is because he did not get redeemed and you did. Are y'all there? Now, study the book of Enoch. You'll see why God would not redeem Satan and those 200 angels that caused men to fall. Now, this document describes nothing less than the global takeover of every nation across the planet. The goals of this document are nothing more than code words for corporate government fascist agenda that will imprison humanity in a devastating cycle of poverty while enriching the world's most powerful globalist corporations like Monsanto and DuPont. Now, in the interest of helping wake up humanity, I have decided to translate the 17 points, remember that, the 17 points of this 2030 agenda so that readers everywhere can understand what this document is really calling for. To perform this translation, you have to understand how globalists disguise their monopolistic agendas in feel-good language. In other words, one of the greatest ways that we have slid into this slippery slope of degradation is to change words or change terms. That's why when we call fornication, fornication, you know what it is, you feel convicted the minute I said it. The minute I say fornication, you feel convicted no matter what. But we've changed that word, are y'all there, into a friend or affair. Affair is adultery. See how we can, but if you change it to affair, it lessens the blow. And so the way they have caused the people to receive the worst of society is by changing the term and calling it something else. See, homosexuality used to be sodomy. Straight word. No, sodomy gives you the image and the picture of what it is. Are y'all there? If you change it to gay, it just turned the whole meaning of what it is. This ain't happiness. Are y'all there? And so you must understand how we have a media that would switch up terms in order to get you to swallow it. You got what I'm saying? But because they understand that you cannot, man has a conscience that is triggered by certain words. Certain words bring certain images, and those images cause a person to be turned off. But if they could change the term, then it'll slide on by without a person's red flag coming up. Y'all heard? That's why they change terms. You do it. You do it when you write up your resume. You cook fries at Burger King. That's what you are. You was a fry cook. What you put on your resume, fried, food technician, you know, you cook fries. You work the cash register, but on your resume, you are a customer service associate. No, you are a cashier. Why do we do that? Because changing terms is deceptive to cause a person to not understand exactly what I'm talking about. Giving myself something to be greater, or even I can use terms to make something seem less. Are y'all there? The word for this is called revisionism. Revisionism. Our country is real big at that. That's why we don't know history, because they revised it all. Are you there? Now, so the reason why our country and the media use revisionism, because it's to slide stuff by, put it right in your face, and have certain terms that you don't really see or understand, and it'll slide right by you. Now, by the time you look up and figure out what you actually agreed to, you won't understand it until you realize they implement it, and then you will say, oh, I didn't know this was what they were talking about. So that's why they use this coded language. You got what I'm saying? Now, here's the point-by-point translation. Notice how carefully that nowhere does this document state that achieving human freedom is one of its goals. The goal is not to set people free. The goal is to use the environment to bring you into bondage. Making like we don't have enough land or enough water or enough resources. And the goal is to snatch people's land. They already said you don't even own your house, even though you paid for it. You don't own it. Nor does it explain how these goals are to be achieved. As you see here, every single point of this UN agenda is achieved through centralized government control and totalitarian mandates that resemble communism. So how do you turn a libertarian, freedom-loving nation into a communist nation where they are totally dependent upon a dictator without them knowing it? Without them knowing it. You got what I'm saying? Now, translation of the UN's 2030 Agenda Blueprint for Globalist Government. Goal one. It's the first goal. Remember, they have 17 points. Y'all got that? This is what their goal is. And this is how, remember how they word stuff. Because the way they word it sounds great. Who wouldn't want this? First goal. End poverty in all its forms everywhere. Ain't that a good goal? But let's translate what they're really saying. Put everyone on government welfare, food stamps, housing subsidies, and handouts to make them obedient slaves. The real goal for welfare was to cause you to become a slave. That was why the government will never give you anything that they don't want something on the back end for. The old adage is true. You never get nothing for free. The reason why they didn't mind doling out all of these subsidies and entitlements, because they could control that household. When they controlled that household, all they had to do was promise you some more entitlements, and you will vote the way they tell you. You will live where they tell you. Your kids will go to the school they tell you. You'll raise them the way they tell you. The drugs they tell you, put them on, you'll do it, because that's what welfare was. It was designed to control people through entitlement. Come on, say control through entitlement. Meaning I'm making you think you're getting something, but what you're getting is me controlling you. Y'all there? Now you would think that people don't know that, but people know that. They just accept that. They accept it. You get lazy enough on welfare, you accept it. Look, it says obedient global. Okay, never allow. Now, this is what this, we're still translating the first point. Never allow people upward mobility. Is that not welfare? Amen. To help themselves. Instead, teach mass. That's why when Obama got in office, everybody got on food stamps. They start letting you stay on unemployment for 99 weeks, getting everybody used to entitlement. Why do you think they got everybody used to entitlement? Why do you think they doled out all this Section 8, all this public housing? Why do you think the government did that, gave everybody food? You can call that and don't even have to be a legal a citizen and get food stamps. Why? Why do they want everybody on the government payroll? Because they want you to get used to it. Now, once you're used to it, there's coming a time where they're going to snatch all of it. Now, to get this, you're going to have to sign up for this mark. Get everybody hooked on it, and then give them, then snatch it away, and then make form a line. And in order to get this entitlement, you got to give up your freedom. That's when the Bible says you won't be able to buy or sell, because the government will be in control through Monsanto of all the food they are there now. They poisoning your water, so they'll be in control of the water too. And a foreign country already own your energy, so they'll have you in the dark, like they cutting the lights off in Venezuela, where they in the dark half the day. This is where we're headed. The Agenda 2030 is putting every nation in a third world state. That means all these developed nations will be broke and in a third world state, depending upon these elite at the top to dole out the crumbs. Y'all there? Now, Never allow people up with mobility to help themselves. Instead, teach mass victimization. That's where we are now. Everybody's a victim. Everybody's a victim. Y'all notice white folk won't be victims. White folks screaming reverse racism. White folks are saying discrimination. I don't know how they can come up with that when they are the most discriminatory people there are. But everybody's screaming, the police are victims. Blue Lives Matter. Everybody's a victim. Teach victimization and obedience to a government that provides monthly allowance money for basic essentials like food and medicine, labeling it the end of poverty. And let me tell you what this global 20, this gender 21, this gender 2030 agenda really is. Everybody gonna be living like black folk. Everybody is going to become ghettoized. The whole world will be a ghetto. I'm telling y'all what they're doing. For some of us, might just be walking right on into one. It might not be too hard. Goal two. Now, this is the second goal of the 17th point of the Agenda 2030 for globalization or the New World Order. Y'all there? The second goal is to end hunger, achieve food security, and improve nutrition and promote sustainable agriculture. Man, that sounds great. Ain't those great things? End hunger? Yes, we want that. But the true transnational, you got to match what their agenda is with what they're actually doing. You know how you ever been with a dude that told you or sold you the dream? And you was listening to what he said and you wasn't looking at what he was doing? Are y'all there? He gave you a steady diet of fentanyl. I'm finna get a job. I'm finna get on my feet. I'm finna get a car. Steady diet of fentanyl. And you were so hooked on fentanyl, you never looked at what he was actually doing. And if you imagined what he's doing to his fentanyl, you wouldn't have believed it. So the reason why we're translating is because we're not going off what they're telling us. We're looking at what they're doing. Are y'all there? Because, yes, they're going to achieve these goals, but how? How is the New World Order? It's not enough to say the New World Order no more. We in it. How? Detail. Tell me how it's going to happen. Are y'all there? Now, translation. Invade the entire planet with GMOs. Genetically modified organisms. That means mess up your food. And Monsanto's patented seeds while increasing the use of deadly herbicides under the false claim of increased output of food crops. Engineer genetically modified plants to boost specific vitamin chemicals while having no idea of the long-term consequences of genetic pollution or cross-species genetic experiments carried out openly in a fragile ecosystem. That means they're going to literally experiment, give you a Frankenstein food, everything just to make more of it, but not probably going to have nutrients in it, just enough to keep you alive. But they'll be ending hunger. Goal three. Ensure healthy lives and promote well-being. Remember, the Agenda 2030 is they telling you what the plan is, but they're not really saying how they're really implementing. I'm just giving you a vague understanding of this is what that's like a wish list. This is what we really want to do. But where is the actual proof that you can accomplish this? Well, there ain't no proof, because how can a country that's $65 trillion in debt cause you to live well? See, the $65 trillion that America owes, it's a secret they ain't telling you. I don't really want to get in this, but if I really get deep, I'll tell you something. America's $65 going up to $70 trillion. You can't pay it back. There's no way to pay this money back. Obama and them cut a deal like back in 2009. The deal was to give America to the UN. This is the reason why they don't obey the Constitution, because the Constitution has been ratified based upon the fact America has defaulted on its debt. America is a corporation. It's defaulted on its debt. So because it has defaulted, what happens if you default? They start moving in and seizing what? Your assets. The last assets of America is the people, because they already took the resources. Any of the coal, the gold, the oil is taken. The land has now been taken by China. Ain't nothing left but you. You are the last asset. That's why you have a social security number, so they can say you are part of the debt. America has been gone. A republic is a corporation. Y'all don't want to talk about this. I want to help y'all. Come on, think. No, Black Lives Matter. I'm trying to show y'all. All of that is a farce to keep you from knowing what really already happened. That's the reason why, as I begin to really study this, I said, there ain't no really solution but Jesus Christ. But go, die and go to heaven is where I'm at. That's where I'm at now. I don't know nothing else to do. Ain't no other way out of this. That's why Jesus said, when you see these things, look up for your redemption drawing nigh. Love not your life unto death. Get yourself right with God, because that's all you're going to have. Only thing they ain't going to be able to take from you, because they're going to take everything else. Only thing they're going to take is your death. That's the only third place you're going to be free. Y'all want to talk. Now, y'all ready to get raptured. That's what it is. They rapture and catch right in the FEMA camp. They ain't building these caskets and coffins and prisons for nothing. Are y'all there? Now, I'm trying to give you detail of the New World Order. How many of y'all been hearing this preach for years? The New World Order, New World, the end of the world. Okay, they never tell you how. This is it. This is what the Bible is talking about. Y'all there? And not only, not when they implement it, they're implementing it. It's happening. It's happening. The only reason they have not imploded this system or destroyed the system, this cash system, broke our economy, the only reason they haven't done it is because of the guns. Listen to me. It's guns. The UN, listen to me, the UN already has control of America. The UN knows that they do not want to send those soldiers here to fight these Americans. It's one thing about us is that we are a freedom-loving people, and we will fight. We got more guns in the nation. Did you know we got twice as many guns as people in this nation? So we strap here. So what they're trying to do is to force us to voluntarily give up the guns so there's not a big war. You got what I'm saying? Now, they did it in England because they kept doing false flags in England and Australia, and they sit up and said, well, let's give up the guns because, you know, they made it like it was the guns itself. So when the England people gave up their guns, they cannot stop the Muslims from coming in their country. That was the goal. They're at the mercy of their government. The reason why the Second Amendment was put there, which y'all know they really, the Second Amendment didn't apply to us. And that's why they shooting brothers that's got legal guns, because they don't see you as a legal person that's supposed to have a gun. The Second Amendment was for white people. When we start exercising it, they pass laws. When the Black Panthers start taking up open carry, they banned open carry in California when the Black Panthers took it up in Oakland. But anyway, but the Second Amendment is for you to watch your government. So your government can't come and take from you. It was for a militia to get together and riot against the government if the government became tyrannical or totalitarian or dictator. So for y'all that's listening to the liberal lie that guns are killing folk, that's a lie to make you give them up. Then when once you give these guns up, there's nothing that's going to stop those stormtroopers from the UN knocking on every door and putting a mark on your door and bringing you out and taking whoever they want out of there and hustling people off to the FEMA camp like they did in communist Russia under Stalin. So they're waiting on the guns. That's why every month now, and it's been happening more regular, they keep doing false flags. What do y'all think they're doing? Go back to Sandy Hook. FBI paper said nobody died in Sandy Hook. FBI said nobody died. There's no death certificates in Sandy Hook. How did 22 kids die if there's no certificate? You got to think about this stuff. I told you the Dallas shooting with the police. Somebody did die, but that boy didn't do it. Somebody did die. Those police did die, but they messed up because I told you the boy sit there and got the cell phone footage of somebody shooting when they kept wanting it to be the guys in the air. They kept saying when it first happened, it's two snipers up on the parking lot roof. But because this guy happened to be in this spot on the side of the building with a cell phone, they couldn't make it the lone wolf scenario if they let it be two up there. Because see, three or more than one shooter means a conspiracy. That's why every false flag has to be a lone shooter. The Orlando shooting, FBI file said in Orlando, nobody died until the FBI got there. That man was in there, they said, shooting for 3 hours. But they said nobody died until the FBI showed up. It's a false flag. Why are they doing that? To garner sympathy and outrage. So you'll say, you know, it is the guns. Or it's the gun. And you give up your weapons, and then they like, nothing's stopping us. Because the soldiers that's going to come in really don't want to shoot you. They don't want you to shoot them. And so they want you to give them. Now, because they realize, because they try to take those guns up in Massachusetts and it didn't work, the people bucked. They said, well, y'all got to come get us. They realize America's, we ain't giving up. White people ain't giving up. White people ain't giving up nothing. Not no guns. They too scared to give up their guns. So they realize white people ain't gonna give up. We ain't giving up no guns. So now what they doing is they're going to, they realize we just gonna have to declare martial law. But you can't just declare martial law. You gotta have a something happen for martial law. So let's stir up racism. Let's get it so deep and heavy to where they ready to fight and riot. Now what we got going on is a racial tit for tat. Y'all got to realize they hit us, we hit them. That's what they want to start happening until it's all out us against them. That's what they're trying to get. Now, even though we're not doing that, the media's doing it. Because they stuck on the police that got killed in Dallas and keep saying the black boy did it. But there was a white boy just yesterday that shot two sheriffs and no media covered it because it was a white guy. Now, if they really cared about cops, why ain't they showing that? Because they want the scenario of the black against the white. Now, the reason why they hurry up and done Dallas was because we was getting stirred up with the fact they shot those two guys and we saw it, and black people that won't even say nothing start saying stuff, and they knew we had, listen, we had the righteous upper hand. That means we was in the right. So what they did to kill that was to go and do a false flag and make a black dude, a 25-year-old dude, is ramboing on the streets of Dallas. I don't believe it. But now, what happened right after that? No more, they ain't mention those two boys' name no more. And now every time you cut it on, it's about the cops, and they doing a slow funeral, and they drawing it out. Why? Yes, that's a sad thing that happened, but the point was, blacks were getting stirred up to unify, and that's what they was afraid of. That wasn't a plan. So that's why they did that. So they had to do something, and they stole the attention back to because even other nations were speaking out against this, what happened. Other nations have put, down in the Bahamas and Jamaica, put a warning for their people that America is travel advisory in America. That looks bad. That looks bad, a travel advisory. They said, if you from these island nations, you dark, be careful when you go to America. Now that's what they used to tell us when we go to other nations. Yeah. Let me hurry. Are y'all there? Now. Are y'all ready? So don't get caught up on the foolishness. And what I get upset about is they talk about, Black Lives Matter don't know they're being used. George Soros is funding it, and they being used. Well, we know they funding it. We know, but George Soros using y'all too. Right. Because to stop the New World Order from doing what they're doing, all white people got to do is admit our lives matter. Then we will be together. Then we can't fight each other. They can't have no leverage over us because we all together. But y'all want to stand on the side of the cops. The bad thing about it is, do you not know the ones coming to get your guns, white folk, is the same people shooting us? Once they do it now, the bad thing about it, they're going to be so, have us so far over here that we're not going to be able to help y'all. They doing us first. So say be wise. The end time calls for wisdom so that you don't be running out there getting caught up in emotion and what the media is saying. Say, stick with the word of God. Amen. Now, let's go. Now, goal number 3. Y'all ready? Ensure healthy lives and promote well-being for all at all ages. That's a good goal. Healthy lives. Now, translate what they're actually doing. This is Bill Gates' thing here. Mandate 100 plus vaccines for all children. Now, I just saw something online where a white baby just died right after getting vaccinated. They kill these kids are dying on these vaccines. Bill Gates said that was the goal. Depopulate. He said through vaccines, we can bring the numbers down. That's what they keep trying to do in Africa. Mandate 100 plus vaccines for all children and adults at gunpoint. Make you take it. Threatening parents with arrest and imprisonment. And some of y'all gonna go through this with your children. When you try to send them to school, if you decide you're gonna opt out vaccines, they're gonna force you, and they're gonna it's gonna be a charge. They're gonna make it a charge. Because the goal, I really believe those vaccines got time release stuff in it. I believe that. I believe part of it's gonna be sterile. We're gonna have a whole generation of sterile people. I believe it's got something to do with sterilization. Because the goal is to depopulate. The Georgia Guidestones said that they want to decrease the population to 500 million. That's 6.5 billion that got to go. Threatening parents with arrest and imprisonment if they refuse to cooperate. Push heavy medication use on children and teens while rolling out screening programs. That's the ADAD, all of the psychotropic drugs for the kids. Call mass medication prevention. And claim they improve the health of citizens. Y'all there? Now, goal number four, ensure inclusive and equitable quality education and promote lifelong learning opportunities for all. Good, that's a good point. How are we gonna do it? Push a false history and a dumbed down education under Common Core. You ever seen Common Core math? Have you ever seen it? It's got to be the most ignorant thing that I've ever seen. I don't even know if you really come up with the right answer. I think they give you points for being close. I really don't think there's a right answer to Common Core. And you got to go all the way around the bush to do something simple. Because the goal is to see the goal. I told y'all Sunday, the reason why the slave master didn't want the slaves to read is because a person that's educated cannot be controlled. But dumb folk, you can control them. That's why they dumbed everybody down. These cats don't even know how to read. They're going to be dependent on the system. Common Core education standard that produce obedient workers rather than independent thinkers. Never let people learn real history, or else they might realize they don't want to repeat it. That's why they don't want to teach you real history. Goal number five, achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls. Now y'all see where this feminization of boys and this homosexual LGBT agenda as well. Now y'all see why Obama is just 150% behind it, why everybody's pushing it, nobody's saying nothing against it, because that's the actual goal for the New World Order. I told y'all gay was the New World Order. I preached it a while back. Look, translation. Because their goal is to achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls. That sounds good. Empowerment, achieve gender equality. But the translation, criminalize Christianity, marginalize heterosexuality, demonize males, and promote the LGBT agenda everywhere. The real goal is never equality, but rather the marginalization and shaming of anyone who expresses any male characteristics whatsoever. The ultimate goal is to feminize society, creating widespread acceptance of gentle obedience, along with the self-weakening ideas of communal property and sharing everything. Because only male energy has the strength to rise up against oppression and fight for human rights, the suppression of male energy is the key to keeping the population in a state of eternal acquiescence. And that's the reason why they pushed homosexuality on these boys. It was to kill male energy. It was to kill male energy. I told y'all before, Satan always knew women would go along based upon, the Bible says, dwell with your wives according to knowledge, understand they are the weaker vessel. Satan always knew women would go along with the system. That's why y'all go along with the system, but he knew men would rebel against the system. So what do? You make the men gay. You turn them into females so that they will have a feminine spirit and they will go along with the system. Are you hearing what I'm saying? That's why they want homosexuality. See, there's a goal to that. It wasn't just, y'all thought it was about just these two brothers won't have sex and won't love. Did you know that even though now they can get married, they ain't getting married? Because it wasn't ever about getting married. It was about destroying heterosexuality. Goal number six. Goal number six, ensure availability and sustainability management of water and sanitation for all. Wonderful goal. Translation, allow powerful corporations to seize control of the world's water supply and charge monopoly prices to build new water delivery infrastructure that ensures availability. That speaks for itself. Sell you water. That's the goal. Sell you water. Ration water. Number seven, their goal is to ensure access to affordable, reliable, sustainable, and modern energy for all. The translation is to penalize coal, gas, and oil while pushing doomed to fail green energy subsidies to brain dead startups headed by friends of White House who all go bankrupt in 5 years or less. In other words, kill the true resources that actually work and keep coming up with these green resources that cost more money. That's why those green cars cost more money. Those electric cars are more expensive. The green startups make for impressive speeches and media coverage because these companies are led by corrupt idiots rather than capable entrepreneurs. They always go broke, and the media hopes you don't remember all the fanfare surrounding their original launch. Number eight, promote sustain. Is this too much? I can stop. I may not get through all of them, but that's why I said go look up Agenda 2030. You can read it for yourself. Promote sustained, inclusive, and sustainable economic growth, full and productive employment, and decent work for all. Remember I said the wording they're using. Regulate, now the translation is regulate small business out of existence with government-mandated minimum wages that bankrupt entire sectors of the economy. How you gonna pay somebody flipping burgers $15? Y'all are really slow, y'all go for that stuff. Did y'all know when they did that? You know what McDonald's did? They built robots. It's robot. They just took away all the little CFC or the little cashier jobs, and now what they're doing is they've seen, if you go look it up, you see how now the future is to go on the screen and boop 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 boop, and it comes out in the window with no people involved. That's what they're doing. They say, y'all want to make us charge $15 to pay y'all to flip burgers? We'll put on assembly line and get a robot to do it. There's no way you can pay minimum wage. What if you got a business? Let's just say you have a business. How are you gonna pay somebody $15 an hour to do work that really ain't worth about $7 an hour? You really can't pay that and stay in business, especially if you gotta pay insurance on top of that. Plus taxes is the third. I mean, there's no way. What are they doing? Killing all businesses so everybody's dependent on the government. Are y'all there? So listen, that stuff sounds good. You know, paying minimum wage 15, that sounds good, but it can't happen. That's why Bernie said all this stuff wasn't nothing but all that old socialism talk. They can't do it. Now, Venezuela did all of this. Venezuela, look at where Venezuela is. They totally broke and bankrupt. Why? Because they tried socialism, it doesn't work. Now, force employers to meet hiring quotas of LGBT workers while mandating wage tiers under a centrally planned work economy dictated by the government. Make them hire gay folk, which is that law they get ready to pass where even churches will have to hire LGBT. Destroy free market economics and deny permits and licenses to those companies that do not obey government dictates. We're seeing that now when people don't do what they ask, especially with the LGBT, you lose your job, you lose your contract. Goal nine, build resilient infrastructures, promote inclusive and sustainable industrializations, and foster innovation. Translation, put nations into extreme debt with the World Bank, spending debt money to hire corrupt American corporations to build large-scale infrastructure projects that trap developing nations in endless spiral debt. That's what happened in Venezuela. The World Bank go down there and say, we'll loan you money, help you build up your infrastructure, charge them all of the interest of company. The country cannot pay back the debt, and then they default on the debt. Now the World Bank comes in and say, well, I want your coal, I want this, I want that, and then the country goes belly up just like a bankrupt business. That's what they've done to all the nations, the World Bank. Notice they never talk about the World Bank, the IMF, the people who are really doing this stuff. Those are the Jewish bankers, the true Illuminati, that they're not going to say nothing about them. Goal 10, reduce inequality within and among countries. Translation, punish the rich. The entrepreneurs and the innovators confiscating nearly all gains by those who chose to work and excel. Redistribute the confiscated wealth to the masses of non-working human parasites that feed off a productive economy while contributing nothing to it, all while screaming equality. Goal 11, make cities and human settlements inclusive and safe. I may stop on this one. Safe and resilient and sustainable. Translation, ban all gun ownership by private citizens, concentrating guns into the hands of obedient government enforcers who rule over an unarmed, enslaved class of impoverished workers, criminalize living in most rural areas by instituting Hunger Games style protected areas. I told y'all when Hunger Games came out, I said, this is what they want. This is what they really want, to divide the people in certain classes and to have the classes going against each other. And the elite, remember, if you look, the Hunger Games go home and watch it. It is the epitome of Agenda 2030. Because if you really know, remember the Hunger Games, in the city, it was rich, bunch of homosexual looking people, wasting food, had all this stuff going on. And then in the countryside, and remember, the black people was in a prison life. I told y'all, if you look at the Hunger Games, when they went to the black area, they were picking cotton. Look at it close, you'll see it. I said, they taking us back to slavery. Black people picking cotton. And they divided them up in 12 divisions, which is about what the New World Order wants to divide the whole world up into 12 regions, or really 10 regions, divide the whole world up. And so, and then make everybody broke and poor on the same level, and then everybody will funnel all of their resources into this rich city, which I believe that city is in Turkey. There's Azerbaijan, I think that's the city. I can't think of it, I don't think pronounce the name, but it's a New World Order city. This city is built, look up New World Order city. And you will see how they build pyramids and set up. I mean, this is a New World Order city. And so they believe that's going to be the center of the New World Order. They already got the city, the Tower of Babel's there. They got it all built there. Yes, there. Pyramids, it's all built. And it's so low key. As a matter of fact, Google Map used to have it marked by a pentagram. It had a pentagram marking the city because it is... you know how the Bible says that where Satan's seat is? Yeah. I really believe that city in Turkey is where Satan's seat is. Wow. So anyway, but I believe that's the New World Order city. Now the goal is to have the nations of the world, and that's the reason why they must have, remember I said, order out of chaos. Yeah. It has to be chaotic. That's why you have to have your life. Now, you can study the rest of this when you get home. I'm not going to go too deep, more deep. I just want to show you what the New World Order is going to look like. It gets worse than that. Actually, it's worse because this is total control. This is the reason why I told you all you're going to have in the last days is relationships you've built. That's why Jesus said, Father, make them one as you and I are one, because that's the only thing that's going to cause you to live and sustain is based upon the fact you got loving people with a heart of love that's willing to bless you and not see you starve and help you. But what Satan has done is caused us to be so in this world, in this cyber world, that we don't build relationships, we don't know nobody, and when this grid go down and the grid is going down, they wouldn't have made a button to turn it off. They said Obama and them got a switch. When they click that internet off, and you would not be getting in there. Once they do that, all of our ways of communication, we won't even know how to communicate because we don't even know how to talk to each other. We're not building tangible friendships. I was talking to a brother. He said, man, he was talking to one of his partners. He said, he asked his partner, you know, how's your girlfriend and all that? And the brother said, oh, we're doing great, man. We got a good relationship. He said, yeah. And the brother said, he said he had never met her physically. They was girlfriend and boyfriend online. People are not building true relationships. And this is one of the goals that Satan is getting people to separate from true connections, of tangible connections, so that you don't have to, you won't be able to help or need each other. Your love won't come out. Are you understanding what I'm saying? That's why I'm telling you, build relationships. Come on, say, this is one of the goals why he's keeping people from going to church and tell them ain't no good churches and all the pastors are corrupt. A lot of them are corrupt, but not all of them. You need relationship. You need fellowship. You got a fellowship. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Why? Because when things go down, it's only the people that around you that you built relationships with that's going to be there for you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You have to understand that Satan is preparing this world to pledge their allegiance to this beast. And the beast can appear any day now. Any day the system can be imploded. I'm not a gloom and doom preacher, but at some point, when are we going to talk about the end of this book? That's where we are. I'm sorry. I wish I could. Now, all of what we're seeing now is leading up to the setup. Say the setup. This is all a setup to push us in a place. Now, the next thing that you're going to see happen in this nation is martial law. This is what's coming. They're going to declare it. Now, once they declare martial law, every law will be suspended. And the word of one man will become law. That means what Obama say at that time will be law. So that's when they start saying, well, get out now. Let me go and say, go deep. Come on, do y'all really want this? Now, this is deep. Now, the NASA slipped up and said that Nubaru is coming. NASA just said, this guy, it was a NASA scientist that was talking, and he slipped up and said this planet is coming. Now, let me give you an end time understanding of why the world seems to be rushing so fast and things are moving so fast. Russia is about ready to come out and tell the world that the United States has been, and the nations of the world, the leaders of the world, have been in cahoots with aliens. Now, I know that sounds crazy, but I'm telling y'all what Russia said. I'm not saying it's Russia said it. That they have been in cahoots with aliens. That's what they, that these beings have been here before and they are coming. Now, of course we know it's the deception of Satan to make people think this is an alien race, but it's really just going to be the man of sin and his fallen coming back. We know, or just appearing, not coming back, because they're in another dimension. They're getting bodies. I'll talk about that a little later. Now, when they appear, people are going to think this is the Messiah. That's why Jesus said, when they say, lo, here is Christ, don't go to him. Right. Now, but those, now Satan has told the Pope and has told people, has told these Luciferians, and he's told those who are on his team, y'all have to get rid of, before we get there, all of the barriers and hindrances that's going to hinder us. You got to get rid of them. That's the reason why they're going to stomp out Christianity. Because Christianity challenge is the only thing that will challenge the name. Notice why they're taking the name of Jesus away. Because he don't want that. So when he shows up, he wants a cleansed land without the name of Christ, without true believers. Because you got to realize, when these demons come off his ship and you standing there with power of God and you rebuke them, people going to see it's a demon. Yeah. I'm trying to tell y'all what they want. This is war. They want you gone. That's why the Bible says they're going to think that they're going to kill you and say they're doing God a service. Why? Because they're going to think God is not the God of the Bible, but the God is coming back. That God they saw coming in the cloud, calling fire down from heaven, doing these signs and wonders and miracles. And people are going to say, and the Bible says, who can war with the beast? And so that's the reason why he's causing, he needs homosexuality, because they're trying to make it so sinful, because he has to inherit an atmosphere of darkness. So they got to put out the light. So everything you see happening now, if you want to know, why can't we get a righteous victory, one righteous victory, one thing good, why this keeps going down, and you think it can't get no lower, and then they come up with something else, and then a man murders his dog, and then a man wants to be a dog, and the man sued the girl in Kentucky because he couldn't marry his computer. I just seen it. Y'all know the Kim Davis that wouldn't give the homosexuals a license? Somebody sued her because she would not give him a license to marry his computer. Look it up. Look it up. When you think it can't get bad, it get worse. And you got to ask, why so much depravity? Because they're killing the light, because this planet is almost in our atmosphere. And when this planet get here, they need this light, but they cannot have this light with all these Bibles and all these believers. So we got to kill all that. And that's why everybody's in confusion, and they mixing up the people, and they making you give up the name of Jesus, and they doing all this, and they taking away people are going into comedic, and they going into conscious, and they going into that deep false Hebrew Israel, like the deep part of it. They just going too far. Why? Because Satan wants that. Because he needs the true Bible believers out of the way. Because the world, now the Bible says in that time, God's going to send them strong delusion because they want to believe it. That means this man that steps off his ship, they're going to want to believe he's God. Why? Because by the time he get here, there's going to be turmoil and rioting and all this stuff going on. And he's going to come and bring some peace and bring some order, and people are going to want to say, hey, I don't care if he's God or the devil. Now, y'all know I tell you, if you really look at, I don't know if y'all seen it, but the latest Superman versus Batman, that really was telling y'all a lot, where actually they was making the Superman character the devil. And remember, he said God don't come from the sky. The devil comes from the sky. What are they doing? That's agnosticism. Turn it upside down, so that you would think that the bad is good. The Bible says in the last days, they're going to call wrong right and right wrong. That's where we are now, where what's wrong is good. If you speak out again, if you two men kissing is wrong, but if you say it, they call it wrong right. Why? Because Satan, listen, he needs a world turned upside down. What does that mean? He needs a world where sin is reigning. So it took him 5,000 years from the Garden of Eden, 6,000 years from the Garden of Eden, to finally cause the world to be conducive enough, or cause the atmosphere of the world to be dark enough for him to appear. That's what he's been waiting to do. Wow. Took him 6,000 years. He had a 6,000 year plan on how he was going to come in. Now, if you don't believe me, that's the reason why they, in Genesis 6, he was trying to implement that plan, and then Satan made sure that the book of Enoch wasn't in the Bible, because the book of Enoch was telling you exactly what the end time plan was, because he had the plan 6,000 years ago. Why? And that's the reason why he did it that way, because he wanted the people to think this is a new thing. But all throughout the Bible, God was saying there's nothing new under the sun. And Jesus said it to be just like in the days of Noah. What was he doing? He was warning us about this. The same thing that happened is going to happen again. So these fallen angels that came from the sky, they're coming back again. And so they're getting the world ready. Agenda 20, listen to me. Agenda 2030 is preparing the world for Lucifer. But in order to prepare the world, the people have to be totally in control, because the goal is to give the people as a sacrifice to the beast, giving them, and then they go back to the way the Aztecs was snatching people's hearts out. That's why they was sacrificing. They're gonna go back to true human sacrifice, because the beast is gonna need that. The Bible says for 3.5 years, 3.5 years, he gonna make a good dent in the world. The Bible says there'll be death like there's never been before, like you've never seen before. So that's coming, a great, great, great destruction. It doesn't preach well in church. That's why I tell people, live for him. Give him your whole. You don't have time to figure this out. You don't have time to go out and see if you can sin a little bit and club a little bit and hip hop a little bit. You ain't got time. What you ought to be doing is understanding I got a fight coming, and right now I thank God for training, that I got time to train and train and train and train. So by the time I got a fight, I'm strong enough to fight. So that's why I told you, all this little stuff you're going through is training you for the big fight. All you doing is dealing with your lion and your bear, like David dealt with his lion and his bear. But the real fight was not the lion or the bear. The real fight was Goliath. But God had to strengthen David. He had to train David with that small stuff. So this little affliction that you're going through now is strengthening you for the real war that's coming. You know, you this loneliness you're dealing with now is strengthening you for the real war. This anger, getting over your attitude, all this stuff, God's breaking you in, being faithful in the least, is training you for the real war that's coming. You ought to be rejoicing that God favored you enough to to strengthen you with adversity. Because Satan might get us all at one point, but he ain't gonna get me first. He won't get me first. I'll be fighting for a while. Because the goal is to endure to the end. Come on, say to the end. Say endure to the end.